Thank you very much, Ambassador Brownback, dear colleagues, ministers, secretaries of state. I'm very pleased to be here. And through Ambassador Brownback, first of all, I would like to praise the United States government under the administration of President Donald Trump, and especially also Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, for their leadership in promoting religious freedom. To have the largest economy and the most powerful country in the world taking this kind of responsibility is essential to our capacity to promote meaningful change in this endeavor. Brazil is proud to be a founding member of this alliance. Brazilians believe in the transformative power of faith, and we are keen to stand together with the other like-minded nations in order to defend international religious freedom and belief. Securing this fundamental right enshrined in Article 5 of the Brazilian Constitution is a top priority for our government. President Jair Bolsonaro continues to actively champion religious freedom at home and abroad. He has taken decisive action towards the recognition of the central role that religion and the spiritual life play in the lives of millions of Brazilian citizens. Earlier this year, as local governments enforced social distancing measures around Brazil, President Bolsonaro ensured that religious services of any nature were included in the list of essential activities that should not be discontinued, provided proper observance of the health guidelines. On the external front, Brazil is deeply concerned with religious intolerance and violence against religious communities around the world. Brazilians value our nation's rich religious diversity, the result of centuries of interaction among diverse cultures. All religious expressions are equally respected and protected here. At the same time, we also recognize our predominant religious faith, Christianity, as a foundation and a pillar of our national identity. Addressing the UN General Assembly last September, President Bolsonaro called upon the international community to protect religious freedom and to combat Christophobia. We are not ashamed of our identity, and we will not turn our backs to the plight of Christians, by many accounts one of the most persecuted religious groups in the world, which is a part of the plight of people of all faiths, which face so many difficulties and challenges in expressing their faith and living and practicing their religions in today's world. Mainstream culture, formed around political correctness, does not acknowledge the due place of religion and the spiritual dimension in human life. It treats faith with contempt and hostility. This is perhaps no less serious than the physical violence and persecution. It is more subtle and pernicious than violence, because it delegitimizes faith inside people's minds. But both challenges must be taken into account. The Brazilian government is currently setting up a specific resettlement facility to welcome refugees and asylum seekers who underwent persecution for their religious beliefs. We are working for the pilot project to be in place early next year so that the first families may benefit from this innovative program by that time. Within our region, we shall continue to fight authoritarianism. In Venezuela, Maduro's crimes against humanity are not sparing the faithful. Cardinals have denounced his use of anti-hate laws to prosecute Catholics who spoke out against him. In Cuba, the government demolished the temple in Santiago de Cuba. A pastor who recorded it was arrested. Religion and spirituality are key to the inherent dignity and worth of the human person. Tyranny is their enemy. Free minds will lead the way to democracy, prosperity, and a worldwide culture of peace. This is our creed and the one pertaining to those who love liberty. Finally, I am glad to announce that Brazil will be very proud to host the 2021 Ministerial to Advance Religious Freedom and Freedom of Belief and the Ministers Forum of the International Religious Freedom or Belief Alliance in dates to be set. Thank you very much.